Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna be talking about Rodin. And I don't mean the French sculptor Auguste Rodin, I mean this, Rodin Gen 1. So there's this little company called Demostech, and they have this product which is called Rodin Gen 1. So Rodin Gen 1 is an AI to 3D thing. So you literally put like an image of something and he creates a 3D model. Now, usually whenever I would see 3D models made by AI, they were not that great, to be honest. But this kind of, like, these models are somehow better, much better actually. And then the developers actually told me that Rodin was actually trained on pure 3D meshes. And now I was curious. So when you go to the webpage of Rodin, well, this is practically where it all starts. This is where you start doing everything. On the bottom, you can see what other users did. And whatever you generate, you have an option to make it public or not. But in general, if I don't know, for example, click on this little dude, on the right, you see the image that was used to create this little dude, and on the left, you see the 3D model, and it's him. Look at it. It's literally him. Like, he even has the backside. That was kind of cool. Now, let me show you how this whole thing works. So Rodin generally has three methods on how you can generate stuff. You can write prompts, generate images, and then create 3D models of that. You can use the thing called fusion. That means that you can literally take, I don't know, a transformer and the ladybug, and it's gonna merge those two into one model that's a transformer-like ladybug-like transformer. And there is a third method that I was particularly curious about, and it's called Multiview. So Multiview is you feeding the AI with, you know, images of one product, like different camera angles, and it's gonna use all those to create an actual 3D model. And I was pretty much impressed with the results. Now, let me show you how it works. So let's start with the text input. Click here, and I'm gonna type cute little black sheep with horns. Press the check mark, and there you go. You got your sheep. If you don't like it, you can regenerate again and again until you're happy. Now, this one kind of reminds me of the whole RenderRam logo, so let's proceed with that. Just hit the check mark and hit generate. After a couple of seconds, you're gonna get this window, and look. You have your first 3D draft of a sheep. If you don't like it, you can click the redo button, and this will regenerate the sheep. And we got this, and I think this sheep generally looks okay. By the way, you can always go to your history. If you click on history here, you can see your previous generations and the stuff that you did, right? And that's it. Here, you can actually see what prompt was used to kind of generate that sheep. So fluffy sheep with a curly wool coat, curved horns, animal character. And what you can do here, if you're not happy with the prompt, you can actually add your own prompt and like regenerate the whole thing again if the prompt was maybe not correct. Here, you can actually choose like what are the some key elements of the model that's being created. So it's a symmetric geometry, smooth edges, it doesn't have sharp edges, and you know, you can just choose a couple of these things. Once you're done, you can click the confirm button here. So this whole thing kind of works with credits. You buy credits, and a model generation is 3 credits. Texturing is 1, but we'll get to that at the very end of the video. And this is the 3D model of the sheep. So there you go. So for the material generation, cool thing is, this will be used, like this image will be used to texture your sheep. But if you click the plus button, you can actually add a completely different image to be used for the material generation. But let's stick to this one for now. Now, when you want to generate this, it gives you an option if you want to crank up the PBR temperature, meaning it will add like the complexity of the detail in the PBR, or if you want to increase the reference strength, which will actually like super closely resemble this little limit. But let's just hit generate. Each model, by the way, takes about 20 seconds to generate, so it's not like you're waiting for forever. And there you go. This is the model of the sheep. Look at it. It's that cheap. You got it. If you go here, you can even choose like how you want to preview it. Do you want to see it as a preview quality, geometry, wireframe, PBR, shaded, whatever. Look, wireframe. Once you're happy with that, you can even redo this. It will just redo the textures and you can get a different type. So if I click on redo here, you will get a different type of the result, but it's gonna be always in the ballpark. I think the eyes here look a bit weird, so I think I'm just gonna stick with the first one. Once you're done, click confirm. And your model is done. So the only thing that you need right now is to choose if you want the shaded material, this is like a baked in material as you see here, or the PBR material, which has normal pass, albedos and everything. And you can choose if you want your textures to be 1K or 4K, you can choose different formats, OBJ, FBX, GLB, whatever, even level of details, high polys. So let's just hit download. And in max, I got my little sheep, and it's just chilling under the Vermeer sky. One thing that I noticed that currently, again, since this is the beta, is not very the best, is how the unwrap looks like. So if I open up my unwrap, you can see that the unwrap, it kind of is packed, but it looks automatic and it's just all over the place. But even that will be improved in the future. Now, I'm gonna be covering the next feature, which is the Multiview. That's that thing where you can upload like multiple images of the same object and it's gonna use that to create, you know, an object. And so these are the images that my client sent to me. And look, I got this chair from a couple of angles. Like, the reference images are not really the best, but let's see what Rodin can do here. So I'm gonna drag 5 images. By the way, you can upload maximum of 5 images. Images can be JPEGs or PNGs. So once these are uploaded, I tried even uploading images that are like 8,000 pixels big and it got uploaded without a problem, so that's cool. So now when you hit generate, you can choose if this is a multiview or a fusion. So I'm gonna choose multiview and we got this. Would you look at that? It's a chair. And I'm generally pleased even with the first generation. Like, I'm not even gonna try to redo. I think it looks generally okay. So let me create that to be my final mesh. And we got this. Now, there is one cool thing. Since Rodin is a sculptor, this thing actually has a sculpting tool in it. Look at this. Once you generate your geometry, you can go to Mesh Editor right here, and when you click it, you got your chair. And now you can use some sort of brushes here, you can choose the radiuses, intensities, and now you can generally sculpt things. Like, you can choose if you want the whole thing to be symmetry or not. You can go negative. If you click negative, it's gonna punch holes inside. But if you're happy with what you did here, you can just click on confirm and that will be processed on your final model. But I'm not gonna do any sculpting, we're just gonna stick it to this. From this point, you can either download this model directly or you can hit generate. That will cost you 1 credit and it will apply textures on it. But the main thing that I'm mostly curious about here is how good and how accurate actually these models are. So I'm just gonna hit download directly. So I've modeled this chair actually already and I know how it needs to look like. So let me compare that to my 3D model. Let's also see how the topology looks on that. On the left, we have what Rodin generated and on the right, you have my chair. And they are pretty damn similar. Look at this. It's very okay. So one thing, it's supposed to have round legs. It made square legs, which is okay, not that big of a deal. I mean, obviously the whole thing is merged into one object, so it's not like you can manipulate it however you want, but look at this. It's crazy. Now, topology wise, this is my topology and this is Rodin topology. I mean, it's actually very good. I did actually a lot of different tests and I did encounter some tests where the topology was not that great, but the majority of it, well, pretty much looked like this. So now this is that point when somebody asks you, like, can you quickly just model something? It doesn't need to be perfect. It will just be, you know, somewhere in the scene. It's not even the main product or anything. I don't see why you wouldn't use this. See what I mean? Like, it's, you know, there's a lot of scenarios where this is actually good enough. So, yeah, well, good job for them. But not only that. Just picture scenarios where you like need to model something and you need to model it perfectly. You can use this so that Rodin generates your object. And you can generally, you know, like do the retopology, or you can just sculpt on top of that object or model on top of that object and use that as a, you know, as some sort of reference, like as a guide. Because I used very, very bad images and this actually helped me a lot to kind of more understand how the object actually looks like. Of course, later on you refine it, etc., etc. But in general, using this as a prop in the scene, I mean, there's a lot of cases where this could work. Using this as a base to start modeling something of your own, like, you know, that has to be super precise, why not? And that's the part that I'm mostly amazed about, you know, from this. Because sometimes I would get such shitty images, like, to work with, and like, I would spend hours just looking at the images and just trying to figure out what the hell is going on here. Look at this. That's cool. Now I'm gonna be covering the last feature and that's the fusion method of generating models. Now that one is trippy as hell. So gonna click the plus button here and I'm gonna choose this chair. Then I wanna merge that chair with this robot and I'm gonna hit generate. and I'm gonna hit fusion. Until this generates, my chair looks like this and my robot looks like this. Okay, so, well, goddamn. Like, those legs really feel kind of mechanical. Now, what's the thing with fusion? Here, you can see, so this portion was used to generate the robot, and this portion of the whole process was used to generate the chair. So, like, if you click here, you're gonna get this little slider. So the more you go to the right, the majority of the chair is gonna look like chair. If you go to more to the left, like, the majority is going to become a robot with like a slight influence of a chair. If I want to kind of add more robot to this, I'm just going to drag it near the middle, something like that, and I'm just going to click redo. And we got this. Look at this. A freaking robotic chair. That literally resembles that freaking robot spider. Okay, let's say we're happy about this. Again, you can edit your prompts here. You can, you know, redo things with, like, you know, if you want to have more sharp edges or smooth edges, etc., etc. So let's confirm this object and let's go to the material stage. And this is where things start to get trippy. So, my robot chair. For the material generation, I can choose if I want to use a chair materials for it or robot materials for it, but no. I'm gonna use a ladybug materials for it because I want that robot chair to be ladybug-ish. And there you go. You got a robot chair that's, you know, that has a seating and back cushions made of a ladybug, and the rest is just the ladybug legs. Now if I hit the plus button again and I'm gonna add the flower and hit generate, I'm gonna get a stem-like flower-like chair. And of course, if you don't like how it looks like, you know, you can always click the redo button. But look, you even have the little veins of the leaves. It's trippy. And that's generally it. That's Rodin. Now, this whole thing costs some money. But RenderRam wouldn't be RenderRam if he would not provide to you guys some points for you to test out. So if you go to the Rodin website here, you have code redemption. If you click here and if you add this code, you're gonna get 10 free points for you to experiment. Roughly for you, so for you to generate a model, it's 3 points. To add the texture is 1 point. But so yeah, you can generate 2 to 3 models with that. If you wish to actually, you know, buy some points, you can buy points directly or you can buy a monthly subscription. Well, monthly subscription is noticeably cheaper. So here you save 33%, here you save 66%. But if you go to refer for free credits, now get this, you click that, you get your referral link. Mine will be in the description, of course. Refer users to our service and they get 50% extra credits on their first payment. Plus, you score 25% of the paid credits too. So yeah, credits for everyone. So if you click here where, for me, it says business, you can actually see what each plan gives you. You know those redo buttons where for me it said that I can do 50 redos? For example, in the creator plan, you can actually do 20 redos. So those are some of the limitations. But yeah, just look at here and see what works for you. So yeah, fun times in general with this whole AI thing. Oh, by the way, you know what's cool? If you find any model here that you kind of like and, you know, you would like to have it in your scene, you can, for example, click on it and you can directly click download here and download this model with textures for 1 credit. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Rodin, thank you for sponsoring this video and see you in the next one. Bye.